Good evening, family. God bless you guys. Always good seeing your beautiful faces. Thank you guys for being here. To the family that will be viewing, and I think the screen just came on. God bless you guys. Thank you guys for being there as well, okay? We're going to open with a different scripture that we've been reading. We're going to read from Ephesians chapter 1. We're going to read Paul's prayer to and for the Ephesians, which is also applicable for us to read to and for and over ourselves as well. I know we're doing the teaching from Brother Hagin's book, The Authority of the Believer, and he emphasizes the importance of reading the scripture, of saying the scripture, and several scriptures that are there in Ephesians as well as Colossians that have a lot of meat and a lot of depth to it. You know, just reading and studying and doing some research, it says more than what we just read on the surface. It says a lot. And the scripture reads from chapter 1, verses 16 through 20. I have not stopped, and actually I'm going to read in the NLT. I have not stopped thanking God for you. I pray for you constantly, asking God, the glorious Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, to give you spiritual wisdom and insight so that you may grow in your knowledge of God. I pray that your hearts will be flooded with light so that you can understand the confident hope he has given to those of us, his called, his holy people, who are his rich and glorious inheritance. I pray also that you will understand the incredible greatness of God's power for us who believe him. This is the same mighty power at the place of honor at God's right hand in the heavenly realms. Amen? Amen.
If you don't mind standing with us tonight, I'm just asking the Timothy team members and the elders and those who help us with prayer, if you don't mind coming up front with us tonight. You know, scripture said, and the church prayed. So we're all joining our faith together, praying. Just want to begin with a prayer of praise and thanksgiving tonight. Asking Elder Roland if he'd start us out. Just want to praise God and thank him. Can't praise him and thank him for you. So as the church prayed, you just begin praising him and thanking him and blessing him. He's just worthy of our praise and thanksgiving tonight.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Oh, Father, we bless you. Father, we worship you. Father, we honor you. Father, we give you the praise. 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 We give you the honor. We give you the glory. Hallelujah. 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 You are God. You are Lord. You are King. You are our rock. You are our foundation. You are our peace. You are our healer. You are our Savior. We praise you. We worship you. We glorify you. Glory to the name of the Lord. Glory to the name of the Lord. Glory to the name of the Lord. Oh, we open up our mouths and we give you glory. We open up our mouths and we give you praise. We open our mouths and we honor you, oh God. We exalt you, oh God. We bless you, oh God. With the fruit of our lips, we give thanks and praise unto your name. Your name is above every name that is to be named in the heavens or in the earth. Or under the earth. Oh, we glorify you. We praise you in this place. We honor you in this place. We exalt you in this place, Father God. Oh, Father God, be exalted in the lives of your people. Oh, be exalted in our lives, Father God. Let your glory be revealed in this place. Let your glory be revealed in our lives, Lord God. Let Christ be seen in us, the hope of glory. Hallelujah. Oh, Father God, we bless you. Father God, we worship you. Father God, we exalt you. Your name is unlike any other name. Your name is higher than any other name. Any name that we're going and we're encountering in our lives, Father God, your name is higher than that name. So, Father, we exalt you. We open up our mouths and we praise you. Oh, Father God, we thank you for this opportunity to be in your presence. For in your presence there's fullness of joy. In your presence there's peace. In your presence there's provision. In your presence there is love. Oh, Father, we thank you for being in your presence. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, we saturate this place with your presence, oh God. Oh, saturate this place with your presence, oh God. As we saturate this place with your praise, with our praise. Let our praise be a sweet incense unto you, oh God. Let our praise be a sweet incense to you, oh God. Let our lives be a life of praise and honor and glory unto you. Oh, we thank you, God. And we give you praise for everything that you're doing in our lives. Hallelujah. You've seen the end. You know our beginning and you know our end. And oh, what a great end we have in you. Oh, glory to God. We praise you. We can't help but praise you. We can't help but honor you. We can't help but exalt you, oh God. Be exalted in this place. Be exalted in our lives. Hallelujah. Be exalted in our communities. Be exalted, Lord God, in our church. Be exalted, oh God, in our families. Be exalted in our children, oh God. Oh, we praise and glorify you.
Hallelujah.
In the name of Jesus, we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Hakatarabosa. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's worthy of our praise. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Hallelujah. We want to pray for those that need healing tonight. I just want to read the list tonight, and then we're going to just turn and reach towards the screen tonight. Please remember Reverend Edwards tonight, Tamisa Hudson tonight, Pamela Scotton tonight, Reggie Say tonight, Winnie Parker tonight, Elder McKelvey tonight, Deborah Hayes, Valerie Walker, Janice Shackley tonight, Imani Jones tonight, Tequina Hudson tonight, Robert Johnson tonight, Lancaster Womack, Troy Smith, Damon Powell, John Washington, Marcus Barkley, Robbie Anderson tonight, London Mazel tonight, Tia Mitchell tonight, Angela White tonight, remember James Tolson tonight, remember Cynthia Ellis tonight. So if you don't mind just turning your hand towards the screen as Elder Keith leads us out tonight. It said, and the church prayed. And even though Elder Keith is leading, you open your mouth. It ought to be a roar in this place that we're praying for those that need healing. You can pray in the Holy Ghost. You can pray in English. But even as he's praying, you're praying. Because it said, and the church prayed. When the church prayed for Peter, something happened. And it's us joining our faith together under the anointing of God, praying and believing for healing tonight.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus for your goodness and for your mercy. We bless you and honor you. Father, even as Elder Roland, Father, was praying to God, just quickening in my spirit, Father, the rainbow word of God was just to continue to bless you. Even as we pray for those who are in need of healing, Father, Father, we thank you and praise you in Jesus' name on their behalf, dear Father. We've come week in and week out and month out, Father. We have prayed for some people whose names are on that list for a year or more, dear God. Father, we thank you and praise you in the name of Jesus. We say what the psalmist said, Father. The psalmist said, dear God, David said in Psalm 103, he said, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me, bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits, for part of his benefits are the fact that he forgives all thine iniquities, and he heals all thy diseases, Father. So God, we thank you and praise you. We bless you and honor you, Father, in the name of Jesus, dear God. Yes, thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Oh, we bless you, God. We bless you, God. We bless you, Father. You have done all. You have provided all. You have provided healing. Jesus, you are our salvation and our healer and our restorer. So in your name, Jesus, we thank you and praise you. That the benefit, one of the benefits that you provided for those names that were read, for those who are viewing, for those in need of healing, one of the benefits that you provided is that you heal all diseases. You heal all diseases, that by your stripes they are healed. By your stripes they are healed, Father. And we thank you and bless you and praise you in the name of Jesus, dear God. We say with them, Father, we declare with them, dear God, that we receive the healing power. We receive the healing virtue. We receive the healing anointing in the name of Jesus, God. We receive, Father. Yes, God. Those who are standing, those who are believing for healing, say this with me. God, I receive. Father, I receive. I receive the benefit that you provided for me. I receive the benefit that you provided for me, Jesus. I receive you not only as my Lord, not only as my Savior, but I receive you as my healer and my healing. And as the psalmist said, therefore we bless you, we bless you, we bless you, we bless you. We thank you and honor you, Father, in the name of Jesus, dear God. We honor you in the name of Jesus, dear Father. We have the assurance, dear Father, not only that as we pray and ask for a thing, dear God, not only will we hear you hear and receive, dear Father, but you want us to be of that mindset that we thank you, that we praise you, that we bless you, that we honor you, that we magnify you, that we worship you, dear God, even in the process. That's part of the process. That's part of the process, dear God. The part that not just that we ask. You said that everyone that asks received, dear Father. So we say in the name of Jesus, receive your healing. Receive your benefit. Receive the anointing of the Spirit of God on your behalf. He died for your behalf. He died for you, for your salvation, for your healing, for your restoration. In the mighty name of Jesus, we speak that to you. We declare that over you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you,
Lord. Hallelujah. 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 We're going to spend a few minutes praying in the spirit, and then we're going to pray in English. And as we're doing that, we're praying for this house, that when people walk in this house, they honor this house, they respect this house, and that the very fear of God would come upon them. If they try to do anything, if they try to say anything, if they have try to act any way they shouldn't act, this is holy ground. And that the fear of God, the anointing of God, the power of God, the glory of God would move in this house. That people, whether it's a funeral, whether it's services or whatever, they wouldn't say whatever they want to say or do whatever they want to say. This is God's house. And we're going to pray in the Holy Ghost. We're going to pray in English. Elder Chanita, if you're going to lead us. Michelle, if you'll help us. Sister Lester, if you'll help us tonight. But we're praying in the Holy Ghost a couple minutes apiece. But we're praying God's power and his glory and his anointing. That when people walk in this house, they honor this house. They respect this house. This is holy ground. Hallelujah. This is holy ground. This is a holy place.
Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Bakita de no mo shatandia basite. Ikolo lo mo sandia basheke rianda da basoto rianda masi. O jala la masatandi obokote riandia baseke. Maje kende obo soto rianda basikolo la mashanda. Inda na mo sete riandi obo sete riandi obokote riamasha. Ielo lo lo mo setendi abakete riono no mo satandia basite. Ashala na mo setendi abasete riobo. no no mo shata. Shika da na mo sandi aba sete di andi de do bo shata. Il na na mo sete di aba sheke li amba sito ro no mo sha. Ma jere de na ma sito ro no mo sanda. Me ke li andi de do bo sete di aba shata. Shange de do bo sete di aba kite de do bo soto. Mindi aba sheke di anda ma sito ro no mo shata anda. Mandi obo soto di andi aba sheke di anda bo sata. Ikale ambo soto di andi aba sete. Mandi obo soto di andi de ba sata di obo sata. Inde da ba sheke di anda no lo bo siya. Mindi aba sheke le no bo shete. Mindi aba sho di anda na ma sata di no lo bo shata. Mikari amba sete le no lo bo shete. Mika yara da ba sete di anda no lo bo setenda. Matali obo soto di andi de ba shike di anda ba sata. Le jere da ma sito ro no mo sata. Mendi aba sete di anda no lo bo shata. Shaka le no bo setindi aba sike di amba sa. Be jere anda bo soto di anda di amba she. La jere da na mo setindi aba sata. Mo kele le da ba shete di anda da ba site. Inde da da ba sata ni no lo bo shata. Minde la lo bo shete di aba sete di obo soto. Mika le da bo sete di aba sata. Ja jere da da bo sata di obo kote di anda ba. Mandi di amba sete li anda. De rorobo shete ikare rorobo satandi obo shata me jerera na masata ne rorobo shete indera rorobo sendi aba sheke ri ana basite mika le rorobo shandi aba sata ma jerera na masite rorobo shanda me kele la basandi obo shoto mendi aba sheke ri andera da basie la shere ri amba satani rorobo sata kele la basete ri omo sho niende da da basito lolono Boshata, indi la 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 basata ni ono no boshata.
Ho ra 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 boshika, ha ra 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 ke 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 koto. Ho ra 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 bashi anda ra ra basheke. Ho kunda ra ra la ka kunda ra ra basheke. Ha ka ra 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 basho ko ra 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 boshike. He keen da da basho ko da 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 basho ko da da bai ha da 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 basho ko da 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 bo kun da 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 basheke he da 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 basho da 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 basho ko da 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 boke ha da 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 baku da 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 basheke ha da 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 basha da 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 bashoke ko he can da. Who can die? Who died in a basheke? Holy Spirit, we are dead in a basheke. Kunda la lobo kunda. Ha da da basheke. Ho kunda da basheke. We love you. Holy Spirit, we thank you. Holy Spirit, right now. Inda da da bashoko do 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 la bakunda, hokunda itai, hukunda da da basheke. Oh God, we thank you. God, we thank you. Holy Spirit, we thank you. Holy Spirit, we thank you. Da 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 basheke, hokunda da da basheke. Inda da da bashata da da bashoko. Hola la bashi kanda la basheke inda la bashukundu
ri anda la kashata broso ya basheke ibri anda la kashata brase yando do kosoto bredi anda la kashata brase yando do kosoto iambrase yando do kosoto iambrase yando do kosoto ianda la kashata brase Brandi and da kasa da sho yambrase yanda kashiti. Breki yambraso yanda da kashata. Bredi and da kashata brasho yanda da kasata. Hiki yambrase yambrosho yanda da kasata. Breki yambrase yandoshe. Yanda da kasiti. Iki yambrase yambrasho yanda da kasata. Breki yambrase yandoro kosoto. Hiki ambrase, breshi ambrase, yambrosho yanda da kasata. Breki ambrase, yambroso yambrase. Breki ambrase, yanda do kosoto. Brase, yambrase, yo yambrase, yambrase. Iki ambrase, yambroso, yambrase. Bridi andada kashata, breshi ambroso. Brashe yambrase. Iki ambrase, yambroso, yambrase. Iki ambrase, yambrase. Breshe yandoso. Yori ambrase. Yori ambrase, yambrashi andodoko soto. Breke yambrase. Shi ambrase. Oki ambrase, yambrashe. Oy ambrase yanda kashata breshi ambroso yanda kashata
hakatarabosha haksaka. Now can you do me a favor? Let's walk through this house and declare it's holy ground. It's God's house. Holy ground. Touch the seeds, walk all over. Holy ground. Holy ground. Holy ground. Wayne, come help us. Holy ground. Pray in the spirit. Pray in English. This is God's house. This is holy ground. This is holy ground. No disturbance here. No cursing in this house. No foul language in this house. Nobody act any old kind of way in this house. This is holy ground. This is holy ground. This is holy ground.
Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah, God. As we walk through this on this hallowed ground, God, this is a place that you set aside, God. You called out this ministry, God, in the name of Jesus, God. And Father God, in the name of Jesus, no foul spirit, God, in the name of Jesus, can overtake what you, God, has blessed, God, in the name of Jesus, God. In the name of Jesus, everyone who comes through to this hallowed place, God, to this holy ground, God, where Father God will come under the subjection of the Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. We praise you, Father, right now, God, because out of this ground, God, you, Father God, raised up Seeds of Greatness Bible Church, God, to do a great work, God, to touch hearts across the world, God. So in the name of Jesus, any devices, God, that the devil and the devil's scheme will be thwarted in the name of Jesus, it will be called out, it will be revealed, it will not succeed in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God. We call you right now, God, in the name of Jesus, that every seat, God, is a holy seat, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Father God. You are a God. You are a God who meets all of our needs according to your riches and glory, God. So, Father, we praise you, Father, right now for what you have done in this ministry, for what you are going to do in this ministry. And we thank you, Father God, for this holy ground, this sanctified place, God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for being covered with your precious blood. Hallelujah, God. Covered in your blood. Covered in your blood in the name of Jesus. We praise you, Father. We praise you, Father. We speak victory. We speak victory. Hallelujah. We speak victory in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 We praise you, God. We praise you, God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. From the roof, God, to the floor, God. This is a sanctified place, God. This is a place that has been set apart, God, to do your will, to do your work, God, in the name of Jesus. So, Father God, we thwart the devil's plans in the name of Jesus. We call him out. He is revealed in the name of Jesus. His plans are upset in the name of Jesus. No victory here. No victory. Hallelujah. We praise you, God. We praise you in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. We praise you. We praise you, Father. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to God. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory
Just keep praying in the spirit. Hashakatarabosa, holy ground. Hatarabosha, holy ground. Hatarabosha kita. Janamosa kata. Hakatarabosa. Hakatarabosha. Janamosa kata.
Haka. Your glory abide to your Father. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you. We thank you.
God, I thank you for your word. I thank you that in Ephesians, you told us that we were raised with Christ and seated with Christ, and that because we've been seated with Christ, that he's given us his authority. So it's in that authority. It's in our habitational authority, because this is our house. We command angels of God to encamp around about us, encamp around this building, encamp in this parking lot, encamp on the ways that come into our facility, at our homes. We release you to minister over us, because we're heirs of salvation. We bind every strategy, every scheme, every tactic, every maneuver of the enemy. We decree and declare that weapons don't prosper here. We decree and declare that plans are thwarted here. We decree and declare that it falls powerlessly to the ground. We decree and declare we aren't children born of calamity, but we're born for signs and wonders, and that'll be the only thing that's manifested here. We decree and declare that we will not be afraid of arrows that fly by day. We will not be afraid of terror in darkness. We will not be afraid of pestilence that stalks in the noonday, because we are hidden in the secret place of the Most High God. I plead your blood over this building, over our members, over our families, every place that the soles of our feet go. You give us the victory. We bind strife. We bind confusion. We bind the spirit of fear. We bind every evil work. For this cause was the Son of God made manifest, that he would destroy the works of the enemy. So we decree and declare the works of the enemy are destroyed. The works of the enemy are destroyed. The works of the enemy are destroyed. Fear is destroyed. Panic is destroyed. Hysteria is destroyed. It will not prosper. It will not work. It will not come together. It will not be formed. Your plots, your plans will fall powerlessly to the ground, because surely my God knows how to take care of the righteous. Surely your hands aren't short. Surely your ears aren't deaf. Surely we call unto you, Jehovah Sabaoth, the God of heaven's angel armies. You dispatch one and you release another. So you are the one we worship. You are the one we praise. We're coming to seek your face. We're coming to seek your presence, that you be worshiped, that you be glorified, that you be magnified. And like it was in Exodus, so that we can't even stand to worship. We can't even stand to worship because your presence is here. We bless you. We praise you. We declare all might and dominion and power and honor and glory be yours. All dominion and honor and glory and power and might be yours. We bless your name. We bless your name.
Hallelujah. Why don't you just lift your hands and praise
glory,
him tonight?
Glory, glory, glory,
this
glory,
is God's
glory.
House. A holy
hallelujah.
Place. We honor you, God.
Hallelujah.
We praise you, God.
Oh,
we bless,
bless
you.
The name.
This is
bless
holy
the name.
Ground.
Bless
we
the name.
Honor you.
Bless
we
the
praise
name.
You. Ha. We bless
the name
you.
Of Jesus.
We
bless
exalt
the name
you.
Of our God.
This is
we
holy
give honor,
ground.
Praise and glory
this
to
is
you.
Holy ground.
Yes, God.
We bless you.
In the mighty
you.
Name of Jesus.
We praise you.
In the name
we thank
of Jesus.
You. We honor you, Jesus.
Yes, God. Yes, God.
Hallelujah.
Blessed be the name.
Hallelujah. Holy ground. Ha-ha. Holy ground.
Yes, sir.
Holy ground.
Yes, yes.
Holy ground.
Yes, God.
Hallelujah.
This is your temple.
Hallelujah.
This is your house. These are your people.
Holy ground.
Thank you, Father. We praise
holy
you in the name
ground.
Of Jesus.
Holy ground.
Holy ground. Living and abiding
hallelujah.
And dwelling in the secret place of the
hallelujah.
Most High. Glory to God.
Just want to end with
glory
the blessing
to
tonight. But this is holy ground.
Yes, it is.
Uh-huh.
Yes,
holy
it is.
Holy ground.
Yes, it is.
This is God's house.
Yes, it is.
Holy ground.
Yes, Lord. Yes, God.
And number 6, 22 through 26, it said, and the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, speak to Aaron and his sons, saying, this is the way you shall bless the children of Israel. Say to them, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace. God bless you tonight.
If you just want him, if you just want him, lift your hands all over the room. Father, we worship you, Father. We praise you. Father, we decrease that you might increase, that people don't see or hear us, but they see and hear you through us, Father. We worship you, Father. My soul longs hard after thee. As the deer pants for the water, so our soul, our very soul, longs for you, Father. We have no other agendas. No other agendas. No other agendas. But to brag on you, to celebrate you, to worship you, to extol you, to lift you up, to magnify your name. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. You can be seated. Woo! Thank you, Father. Whew, God is good. God is good. All the time. Thank you, Father. So, tonight, we are talking about worship. What is worship? Remember, this is going to be interactive. Yes, ma'am. Amen. The praise and adoration of God publicly. Anybody else? All your attention on him. Anybody else? What is worship? Yes, sir. Give him glory just for who he is. Anybody else? Yes, ma'am. Amen. Worship is a lifestyle. One more. Yes, ma'am. Just to sit in his presence. Excellent. 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 Webster's definition of worship: the feeling or expression of reverence and adoration for a deity. The feeling or expression of reverence and adoration for a deity. The Hebrew word for worship is aboda, A-B-O-D-A, or abad, A-B-A-D, or asab, A-S-A-B. Aboda, A-B-O-D-A, abad, A-B-A-D, or asab, A-S-A-B. That's the Hebrew word for worship. And the Greek is latreo, L-A-T-R-E-U-O. L-A-T-R-E-U-O, which means to serve skillfully. Which means to serve skillfully. Also in the Greek for worship, in Jeremiah 13:10, there's a word proskuneo, which is P-R-O-S-K-U-N-E-O. Proskuneo, P-R-O-S-K-U-N-E-O, which means referring to prostrating or bowing down as a gesture of reverence or respect. Also, Paul uses the Greek word liturgia, which is L-E-I-T-O-U-R-G-I-A. L-E-I-T-O-U-R-G-I-A, which is translated to service as in a monetary gift. There's a lot of different definitions for worship. Amen. A lot of times we refer to worship as, you know, a musical or a singing, which worship does involve singing, but worship is pretty much a lifestyle. Amen. Worship is a lifestyle of giving, and it's not just giving monetary as far as tithes and offerings, but it's giving of our time as we serve in the bookstore, as we serve in dance, as we serve in ushers, as we serve in hospitality, as we serve in the production team. How we serve, all those things are acts of worship. And when we worship, we ought to do it, as our pastor would say, with a smile. Meaning with a good attitude. Amen. When we are worshiping God, whether that's in our devotion time, whether it's in our personal worship, it's all about the heart. It starts with the heart. If we get up in the morning or early, or if we're spending time with God just to say, you know, I'm putting in my time, God senses that. We have to worship God with a passion, with an excitement, with an intensity. It takes all of those things in order to truly, truly worship God. It's a matter of the heart. In regards to giving, you could pay your tithes, you could do your offering, but if you have fear, if you have resentment, or if you feel like you don't know what they're going to do with the money, it's going to be hard for God to receive that. If you have resentment in your heart, if you have strife, if you have something going on, it's going to be hard for God to receive that. Amen? Amen. A couple of definitions of worship. Worship is conversation with God, a dialogue that should go on constantly between God and man. Worship is conversation with God, a dialogue that should go on constantly between God and man. Notice that word dialogue. A dialogue is when two people are talking to each other, you know. It's not a monologue. A monologue is when somebody's just talking and 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 talking some more. And what we want to get out of the rut of going to God in our prayer time with just our list of demands, our list of wants, our list of needs. And, you know, we had this big laundry list of desires and things. And then we say amen, and then we go about our way. That is not how we should worship our God. That is not how we should even converse with the God of the universe. Amen? Worship is a dialogue. Worship is... You pray, you talk to God. You know, I would love to get to a point where we are so heavenly minded that our list of demands gets put all the way to the back burner, and we just want to sit in His presence. The scripture in Psalms 42:1. It says, as the deer longs for streams of water, so I long for you, O God. As the deer longs for streams of water, so I long for you, O God. The psalmist compares his thirst for God to a deer's thirst for flowing water. A deer will travel miles. It's an intense thirst. It's almost as if you're underwater and you can't breathe. I mean, it's a desperation to get into His presence, and it's no other agenda but just to spend time with Him. Amen. It's funny that in preparation for the day, I'm home and my son comes home, and you know, he's asked me about my day, and you know, I'm trying to, you know, prepare things like that. But I had to stop and put that to the side, because, you know, he is wanting to spend time with me. He is wanting to ask about my day. He's wanting to know how I feel. He wants to know, hey, you need something, Dad? Let me go in the garage, give me a bottle of water. I mean, whatever, you know what I mean? And he was genuine with it, to the point where I had to stop what I'm doing. And it's going to take us to have that kind of heart, to kind of have that kind of dedication. And it's not a switch that we could turn off and on. It's a lifestyle. It should be a lifestyle. We're talking about the God who is the creator of the universe. We talk about the God of the breakthrough. We talk about the God who is able to hold galaxies in the palm of His hand, who wants our attention. We got to get to the point where we are not just wanting things. I can't say that enough. And granted, God knows that we need things. God, you know, God knows we got families. God knows we got spouses. God knows we have to go to work. God knows we got to take the kids to basketball and track and all that kind of stuff. God knows all those things. But we have to create time for Him. Amen. However you have to do it. Everybody's schedule is different. Everybody's thing is different. But we have to make a conscious decision that I'm going to cut out this time specifically for God. And then throughout the day, you could be in the supermarket and you could just be, you know, whatever. And you could just, you don't have to be loud. You got to make it, but, you know, as the deer pants for the water, so my soul longs hard after thee. Oh, magnify the Lord for me. Let us exalt his name together. And I mean, and that's how you create it to be a lifestyle where you have a constant connection with the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. I'm not talking about breaking out in the dance and all that kind of stuff in the supermarket because you're going to get put out. I am not saying, I am not saying to be on your job and, you know, the presence of God falls in your job, whatever, you will get fired. I am not saying that, you know. Another definition, worship is giving to God, giving him the sacrifice he asked for, which is ourselves. The term liturgios, L-E-I-T-O-U-R-G-O-S, translates as serves or servant. When we are serving God, wherever that is, whether it's our jobs, whether it's in the ministry, we ought to do it with passion. We ought to do it with excitement. I love when Pastor says that what we do here, we are not just volunteers. Amen. What we do here is serving. What we do here is worship. It's worship. It's worship. Amen. I have no idea what's going on, but if you are supposed to be at a position and you don't show up, no call, no show, that is not a good, that's not a good thing, that's not a good way to serve. Amen? Least we can do is call your director or things like that and say, hey, I'm not going to be there. Amen? Because serving is worship. It says it right here. Amen? Now, like I said, I don't know. I have no idea if you know. I don't want nobody to say, "Oh, he talking about me." I am not talking about anybody in this room. Amen. Amen. But worship, serving, is worship. Amen. Is worship. Whether it's cleaning, whether it's hospitality, hostess, ushering, production, sealants, it's all worship. It's all worship. Worship is one's expression of love, adoration, and praise to God with an attitude and acknowledgement of his supremacy and lordship. Worship is also the ability to magnify God with our whole being, body, soul, and spirit. Worship is extravagant. It's love. It's an extreme obedience. Amen. Worship is worship is passion. Worship is the same way I talked about a little bit last week. The same way, you know, we get excited about, you know, whatever hobbies we might have. Nothing wrong with hobbies. You know, we get excited about social media. Nothing wrong with social media. We get excited about football, Super Bowl, what have you. Nothing wrong with those things. But when we're more excited about those things than God. And it's like, you know, we come here and it's just like, you know, I'm putting in my time. That's a problem. That's a problem. And I'm guilty. There's a video that comes up every time around the same time, you know, when you have memories, whatever. And the only one time that I've ever went live on Facebook is when the Eagles won the Super Bowl. And I am literally acting a fool. Acting a fool over the Eagles winning the Super Bowl. And nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with being passionate about whatever, things like that. But I can't be more passionate about that and not be more passionate about the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Amen? Amen. And again, I'm guilty. And there's all, and we are, a lot of times we are in different seasons, different points in our life. Where, you know, different walks, you know what I mean? You know, some people might be, you know, been a Christian 50 years. Some people might be a Christian 6 months. wherever you are, and everybody in between, wherever you are, be passionate wherever you are. Wherever you are, be passionate. Not trying to be, we're not looking for perfection. God is not looking for perfection. If you sin, if you fall short, repent quickly. If you have strife or if you have something going on, forgive quickly. Amen. Got to do it. You got to do it. I know a lot of us are believing for too much to allow certain things like strife and unforgiveness and things like that to hinder our prayers. Amen. Write this down. True worship can only be experienced through communion with God. True worship can only be experienced through communion with God. In John 4, 21 through 24 in the NIV, Jesus gave the greatest revelation of worship in these verses. When he's talking to the woman, Jesus replied, "Believe me, a time is coming when you will worship the Father, neither on this mountain nor in Jerusalem. You Samaritans worship what you do not know. We worship what we do know, for salvation is from the Jews. Yet a time is coming and has now come when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For they are a kind of worshipers the Father seeks. God is spirit, and his worshipers must worship in spirit and in truth." We talked about this a little bit last week, that God is not on an ego trip. He's not looking for worship. He's looking for worshipers. Sometimes we miss that, where we thinking that God is looking for worship, and we should worship God. But he's not looking for worship. He's looking for worshipers. He's looking for communion. Amen. He's looking for relationship. He's looking for relationship. He's looking for relationship. He wants to know you. Now, of course, he knows you, but he wants you. The more that we worship, the more we spend time with God, the more we look and sound and become like God. Amen? Amen? Amen. We are his children, and he wants us to reflect him. And when we reflect him, it's easier to enter into his presence. Amen? Amen. Jesus, in this scripture here, Jesus was showing that worship would no longer be bound to a certain time or place. Neither in Jerusalem, where the Jews worship, nor in Mount Gerizim, G-E-R-I-Z-I-M, where the Samaritans worship. Rather, it was going to be a function of the spirit of man reaching out to the spirit of God. Jesus knew that the time was short when Mosaic sacrifices and rituals would be outdated, and worship would occur within the New Testament temple, man himself, that man himself would become the temple. 1 Corinthians 3:16, "Don't you know that you yourselves are God's temple and that God's spirit dwells in your midst?" In the NIV version, 1 Corinthians 3:16, "Don't you know that you yourselves are God's temple and that God's spirit dwells in your midst?" In the NIV version. You know, way back when, before Christ, you know, in order to worship, they were doing pretty much rituals and doing things, you know, sacrifices and things like that. The Samaritans would go to Mount, in my research, I found out even to this day, that the Samaritans would do, they would go to Mount Gerizim 3 times a year and for them to worship. And that's how they did it before Christ. But when Christ came and he lived and he died and he rose again, all of that was dealt away. All of that was done, because now we're able to worship God, because now we're the temple. And because when we accept Jesus Christ into our heart, we are now the temple, and his spirit actually dwells on the inside of us. That's powerful. Amen. That the very spirit, the same power that raised Jesus Christ from the dead, dwells. That's amazing. To an imperfect people, that he would sacrifice his only son. I love all y'all. Love all y'all. But I cannot imagine sacrificing Little Milk just so that you can choose me. Think about that. That he sent his only perfect son into a sinful world so that people can choose. It's not guaranteed. Everybody's not going to choose God. Some people don't want to have nothing to do with God. Some people hate God. Some people hate everything about the church. Some people hate everything about Christ. And yet he still sent his only son just so that way they would have access to his presence, have access to his spirit. That's phenomenal. And when we go to God with that revelation, asking for things will be so not even important. My kids, just being around me, and if I look at him and I can see he's outgrowing his shoes, I'm getting him shoes. If my daughter is outgrowing her clothes, she don't have to ask me for clothes. I'm just going to just give it to her. We can have that same. Now, again, this is not about things. This is not about stuff. This is not about our needs. And God knows that we have needs. But if we focus, seek ye first the kingdom of God and his righteousness, and all these things shall be added to you. But if we focus on seek ye first the kingdom of God, the things of God, the ways of God, the thoughts of God, and we are concerned about what God is concerned about, the stuff will come. I know I talked about certain things last week, you know, how God has blessed me over the years. And I was thinking today how when I was in college and, you know, God blessed me with this red 1991 Chevy Lumina for $1. And, you know, I was working full time at the Sheraton Hotel, night shift, 11 to 7, going to school during the day. And I was still playing for the church. We used to have rehearsals at Miss Debbie House. This is way back. Having rehearsals at Miss Debbie House. This is when we were still at the Hilton. And there were times where I would be, all of my money and all the scholarship, I think, was going towards school. So I had like, it was tight. Had my little one-bedroom apartment, you know, and then I got bumped up, had a little two-bedroom apartment, you know, things like that, you know, but things was tight. And I would be going to play or rehearse on Sunday at Dell Tech, knowing sometimes I didn't have enough gas to even get home. And every single time, and I wasn't in the car confessing, you know, my God shall supply all my needs according to riches and glory by Christ Jesus. I wasn't confessing, you know, those things that, you know, whatever, you know, and those, all those things are good. But, you know, I would just be in the car. I worship you. There is none like you. No one. I didn't have enough gas to kill. And every single time, you know, I would get, Pastor calls them Holy Ghost handshakes. You know, I would get them from, just it'd be anybody. It could be Brother Victor. It could be Brother Kerman. It could be Brother Mike Piccarelli. It could be Pastor. It could be whoever. And none of them knew what I needed. None of them knew. And that was just because of not just serving the church, not just serving God, but because of my leaning on God in the sense of my praise and worship. You talk about some powerful, powerful moments. I mean, like I said, I know we talked about it last week, but you could have some of the most powerful encounters with God in that car. God is not looking for, you know, you sound like Whitney Houston or Yolanda Adams or, you know, whatever the latest singer got. God could care less about that. God is looking for your heart. He's looking for your heart. He's looking for your heart. It's about the heart. It's about the heart. I can't stress that enough. It's about the heart. He's not looking for perfection. He's looking for your heart. How else would a man called David be, you know, a man after God's own heart, who was an adulterer, who was a murderer, and he would still be called a man after God's own heart? Because David was passionate. David was excited about the things of God. David, you know, when it was time to build the temple, he gave, I don't know how many cubits of gold or how many, it was worth like billions of dollars worth of gold to go towards the building of the temple. I mean, he gave lavishly. He worshiped lavishly. We got to come to a point where we are passionate, 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 passionate about the things of God. I can't stress that enough. If all I said was that, we got to be passionate, passionate, excited. The same way we get passionate about certain things, we got to be passionate about God. Amen. I know I talked about this a little bit as far as the old covenant, how, you know, before Jesus came, you know, they had ceremonies and things like that. And now we're able to, we don't have to go out into our, you know, backyard and or go to the temple and sacrifice, you know, cows or calves or lambs, whatever. You know what I mean? We have access to God. Amen. Amen. Isaiah 29:13 in the Amplified. Isaiah 29:13 in the Amplified. Then the Lord said, because this nation approaches me only with their words and honors me only with their lip service, but they remove their hearts far from me, and their reverence for me is a tradition that is learned by rote. Then the Lord said, because this nation approaches me only with their words and honors me only with their lip service, but they removed their hearts far from me, and their reverence for me is a tradition that is learned by rote. That's, you know, we talked about earlier. It's about, you know, they're talking about, you know, just going through the motions. You know, we come, whether you're home, you know, being a good spouse, being a good father, all those things are a form of worship. Whether we're serving in the house of God with a bad attitude, whatever we're doing, everything has got to be, it's about the heart. It's about the heart. And if you are serving, I can't stress this enough, if you are serving as if, you know, hey, I'm just putting my time in, you know, God senses that. Amen. To worship in spirit is to worship with passion and sincerity. To worship in truth involves the mind. You know, we talk about the scripture, they that worship him must worship in spirit and in truth. To worship in truth involves the mind. To truly worship, it involves the heart and the mind creating a synergy or harmony. Synergy meaning working together. You need to have... You can only worship in spirit, meaning with passion, and truth, meaning with your mind. Meaning that we need to get into that word and know who our God is. Amen. I talked about this a little bit last week, how, you know, growing up, I knew, you know, the stats of all my favorite basketball players. I knew the stats and the height and weights of my favorite football players because I knew them, and these people I never met. But because I researched and I studied and I was literally spending time wanting to know people or organizations that I have never met, it got me passionate about it. And we need to approach the things of God the same exact way. If we want to connect with God in a powerful way, we have got to be passionate about the Word of God. Amen. Which means we've got to be passionate about Jesus. Jesus is the Word, and the Word is with God, and the Word was. Jesus is the Word. If we get passionate about the Word, telling you, our relationship will just skyrocket. We gotta get passionate about the Word. The essence of worship. Worship is not something that's just for the congregation and corporate worship. When we feel the presence of God, worship can happen when we are in our darkest hour. Some of the most powerful times of praise and worship, I know, years ago when we first went through the pandemic, and the pandemic was rough for a lot of different people. In the beginning, it was because, you know, you had so much fear and anxiety, and, you know, we didn't know what was going on, things like that. But I tell you, at home in the dining room where my piano is, those were some of the most powerful times that I had with God. Just sometimes I would just play songs and just play for Him. No laundry list, I just wanted to play with Him and play for Him. And you know, I know everybody here is not a musician, you know, but you can still offer a praise. You can still thank God. You know, the Bible talks about enter into His gates with thanksgiving, into His courts with praise. That's a blueprint of how to get into His presence, to enter into His gates with thanksgiving. Thank you, Lord, for, you know, I don't know what's going on in the world with this pandemic and COVID and things like that, but I thank you, Father, that I'm alive and I'm well. You know, thank you, Lord, for waking me up this morning. Thank you, Lord, for being gainfully employed. You know, those are things that we can do consistently as part of our worship, as part of our spending time with God. Amen? Sometimes when facing tough times, we have a tendency to complain now and postpone our worship for later. My wife doesn't even know this. Today, you know, kids get on the bus, girls got on the bus, and, you know, Nana used the restroom. They went to the bus, they got on the bus. I'm talking about not even 10 minutes from the time we walked out the door to the bus stop to getting back. My downstairs toilet, you know, I don't go in the bathroom, you know, but I hear, and so I'm just ignoring, you know, because it's, you know, I'm just thinking that the fan is on, something like that. Man, I tell you, I go in there 10 minutes later, water everywhere. When I see everywhere, and she don't even know. And so, you know, I'm now, here's the thing, you know, of course, you know, I've been preparing and spending time with God in preparation for this, you know, got up that morning, you know, had my devotion time, things like that, you know what I mean? If I didn't have my devotion time that morning, they might have got a call, hey, I ain't gonna make it today. You know, because you know how it is when you have something going on. You know, the first thing you want to do is complain, and you want to call people and say, hey, this will happen to me, blah, 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 blah. And you know what I did? I went to the bottom of the toilet, turned the water off, got the water up. Nothing but the Holy Spirit. Hey, go into the kitchen cabinet. It was the valve, the flow, which was just spitting out water like crazy. Had another one in my, probably bought it years ago, but I was on Holy Spirit. And usually, I'm tearing the house up looking for something like that. And another one, it wasn't an audible voice. It wasn't, thus saith the Lord. It was not like that. But it was literally got a picture of this part in the cabinet in the kitchen. Went right there, got the part. Took the thing out, dropped the thing in, everything is all as well. But I say that to say that that was a moment where I could have been like, God, I'm doing this for you. I'm serving you. I'm teaching Bible study and blah blah blah, all that kind of stuff. And the toilet is got water every. I'm when I say, if I would have typically, I would come to work, and as soon as they get on the bus, I jump in the car and I'm at work. Today I work from home. If I would have left, we would be having a whole other conversation. it would have been catastrophic, because in the 10 or 15 minutes, that water was literally out of the bathroom. I mean, it was bad. It was bad. It would have been water on the. It would have been probably a couple feet of water on the whole first floor, in the basement. It would have been catastrophic that this water was spitting out that fast in that short period of time. Never happened before. Been in this house 16, 17 years. Nothing like that has never happened before. But, you know, nothing but the devil, nothing but the enemy. Of all days for something like that to happen, it's going to happen today. Distractions. There's going to be moments in your life where you're going to be distracted. But we talked about the cell phone and your faith battery and your worship battery. And if your faith battery is low, if you're on 10%, 5%, 4%, 3%, you know, some of y'all are going to start cussing. Some of y'all are going to complain to every friend you got. And that's not what we're supposed to do. Amen. You got to make sure that your battery of praise, that percentage is high. Amen. Constantly. And the way that you get it high is through your devotion time, through your prayer time, through spending time with God. Amen. We talked about this already. Now is when the true worshipers will worship the Father. Worship operates in the present tense. Worship is always now. Worship is always present. It's a lifestyle. Say that. Worship is a lifestyle. It's how we live. Amen. Now, worship, like tonight, is learned. A lot of times, you know, we talk about, you know, faith, and we talk about healing, and we talk about prosperity, and we talk about, you know, all these different things, but a lot of times we don't hear a lot of messages on praise and worship. We just assume that praise and worship is, you know, music, singing, and praise and worship, well, let's start here. Music is not praise and worship. We talked about that already. Music is a vehicle. It's a catalyst. You see what I'm saying? It's an easy way for, well, let's just say easier way to help us get into the presence of God. Good worship song, good praise song. It's an easy way of getting into the presence of God. David, being out in the desert somewhere with the sheep and all that kind of stuff, making up worship songs, you know. Just for God, and God loved that, and that was their way of, you know, spending time with each other, you know what I mean? Having some good worship music is great. It's great, but worship and praise is not just singing, it's not just music, it's a lifestyle. Amen. It's a lifestyle. I can't stress that enough. We talk about worship as learned. Blessed are those who have learned, and this scripture backs it up. Blessed are those who have learned to acclaim you, who walk in the light of your presence. Blessed are those who have learned to acclaim you, who walk in the light of your presence. Psalms 89:15 in NIV. And I looked up the word acclaim. It means to praise enthusiastically and publicly. Amen. when we give our, giving our testimonies and things like that, you know, those are inspiring. Those are acclaiming the things of God. Those are those are ways where we are magnifying who God is and what he's done in our lives. Amen. We talked about worship as a lifestyle. As soon as we wake up, I want you to try to break the habit of getting on your phone and scrolling and checking your social media. Or just whatever, you know, whatever you do on your phone. Try to break that habit. The first thing now, if not a lot of you use your phone for the Bible app, which is great. You know, I have a lot of different YouTube channels where I can go to where it just plays good worship scriptures. It might play faith scriptures. I mean, social media, YouTube, and things like that are great tools. Great tools. Great tools. But it can also be crazy as well. And, you know, I'm not going to go into that. But we need to make sure that we are using these tools for the things of God. Nothing wrong with having social media. Nothing wrong with, you know, TikTok and all that kind of stuff. Nothing wrong with that. But when we, and I'm guilty of this too, you know, I talked about this last time. I'm a professional scroller. I very rare do I post anything, but I might scroll and it'd be an hour can go by and it feels like 5 minutes. And then, you know, it might be a thing where, you know, life is hectic and, you know, I'm having my little devotion time and I have my little 10 or 15 minutes and it's like my whole mind is not even focused on the devotion. My mind is thinking about, okay, I got to go here, I got to do this, I got to do that, I got to pay for this, I got to do that. And my focus is not even on who I'm supposed to be worshiping. And we are all guilty of that. Let's try to change that. Let's try to change that. When we have our devotion time, let our focus, as the deer pants for the water, so my soul longs hard for thee. Pant is a word of desperation. It's like being underwater, and it's like if I don't get above this water, I'm going to die. It's being so. That's what the psalmist was talking about. When as the deer pants for the water, so my if I don't get into the presence of God, I am going to die. And sometimes spiritually, we are dying. When we go days, weeks, months, years without spending time in his presence, you know, a lot of times church on Sunday is a good charge, but then by the time you get to Wednesday, that battery is low if you're not spending that time, that devotion time. And so now you get another charge on Wednesday, and now you got Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and now Saturday, you know, you got busy and things like that, and this is a cycle that happens year after year after year, and then we wonder why we're stuck at a certain place in the things of God. We got to make some choices. We got to make some changes when it comes to worship, when it comes to praise. Has to make, and again, I'm not just talking about, it's a lifestyle. If you don't get anything out of what I'm talking about tonight, praise and worship is a lifestyle. It's not just on Sunday morning. It's not just on Wednesday night. It's not just when I'm serving here at the church. And, you know, in the back of our mind, it's like, okay, I got to check. I didn't put my time in this week, so I know me and God good. So now I can go weeks and months and years and, you know, it's dust on the Bible. You know, there's a part of your phone where you can kind of see how long you've been on certain apps. And them social media apps is ridiculous. And then the Bible app is like, let's keep it real. And we got to remember, we get busy. God knows that you get busy. This is not a condemnation. This is not getting on anybody's case. We are all guilty. I've got two hands up. Because we all get busy. We all get busy. This is not a you know, you're going to hell. You know, this is not that kind of message. that's my father there, you know. This is not a message to condemn you. This is a message to let's get back into alignment. Wow. It's 8:20. Worship is a lifestyle in the way we treat our spouses, our children, our coworkers, the waiter at the restaurant who messes up our order. It's how we give our tithes and offerings. It's how we serve our local church as an usher, as a hostess. It's how we serve in different ministries. It's how we serve in ceilings. Do we serve skillfully and with love, or do we serve with hate and anger in our hearts? Do we serve our spouses with anger and resentment and strife? Do we, when the child wants to spend some time with you, do we put them to a side because we're on social media? Or because we're watching the game? Something to think about. Worship is a lifestyle. It's a lifestyle. It's not singing. It's a lifestyle. And everything that we do and all that we do and everything we have, everything that we have, we should do to the best of our ability because we serve the only God. Amen. And I'm going to close with this, with the benefits to worship. The benefits to worship is the presence of God. Amen. He is the reward. He is the prize. Everything else is just a byproduct of being in his presence. Amen. He is the reward. He is the benefit of praise and worship. If you can get into his presence, his presence is worth more than whatever lottery. His presence is worth more. I mean, just for have the peace, to pass all understanding, to have the benefits to know that the King of Kings and Lord of Lords has your back in every situation, you will live and walk differently knowing that you have access to such a person. You know, think of the richest athlete or whatever, the CEO of whatever company. If you knew that, you know, because you hang out with them, you know, you pretty much have access to anything. It's the same exact thing. But you got to spend time, relationship. Psalms 34:9, in the Message. Worship God if you want the best. Worship opens doors to all his goodness. His goodness could be many things. His goodness could be protection. His goodness could be healing. His goodness could be favor. His goodness could be, there's so many things his goodness could be. But all of those things are nice. All of those things are cool. Nothing wrong with those things. Nothing wrong with having a big house. Nothing wrong with having a nice car. Not saying all that. But our Heavenly Father, he is the reward. Yes, he is the prize. Somebody say, God is the reward. He is the prize. Everyone stand. Worship team, musicians, I'm asking you to come up as quickly as possible. 8:24. Okay. I did better than last week. Last week we went way over.
I know I'm gonna have to repent for that later. Cause I want to be respectful of everybody's time, But I just want to end with some worship, amen. I say, I want to lift the hands and worship the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. You're worthy to be praised. You're worthy to be magnified. See, once you get a lesson on praise and worship, all of this is different now. Lord, we worship you, Father. Out of a heart of gratitude, out of a heart of thanksgiving, we enter to your gates with thanksgiving and into your courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. We worship you, Father. We magnify your name. We praise you, Father. We magnify your name. We worship you, Father. Come on, we're going to worship together like one big choir. Come on, everybody. Say, you, Lord.
You.
No one,
and no one can worship you for me.
For
all the things you've done for me.
He's done so many things for us, church. And no one,
and no one can worship you for me.
Here's my worship.
Here's my worship.
All of my
Receive my worship.
Say, you, Lord. He's worthy, church. He's worthy. And no
one can worship you for me.
For
all the things you've done for me.
And no
one, and no one can worship you for me.
Here's my word.
Receive my worship.
All of my worship.
Here's my worship.
All of my worship. Father,
receive my worship.
Everybody,
and I will not be silent. I will always worship you
as long as
I am breathing. I will always worship.
And I will not be. It's a lifestyle. as long as I breathe. It's your breath. It's your breath in our lungs. I will always worship. Oh, and I will not be. As long as I live. Oh, and I will not be.
I will always worship you.
As long as I breathe. Come on, lift your hands all over the room.
You, Lord, you are worthy. And no one can worship you for me. For all of things you've done for me.
You've done many things, many things, many things.
No one can worship you for me.
One more time. You, Lord.
You, Lord, you are worthy.
And no one
can worship you for me.
For all the things. And no one, here it is,
it's my worship,
all of my worship, Father,
receive my worship,
all of my worship,
oh,
here it is,
it's my worship,
all of my worship,
receive my
oh,
here it is,
it's all about you, Jesus, 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 it's all about, it's all about. No other redeemers. He is my worship. Father, come on, seeds, and know.
No one can worship you for me.
For all the things
you've done for me.
And no one
can worship you for me.
One more time.
Say you, Lord. You are worthy,
and no one for protecting me from dangers, for waking me up this morning, starting me on my way. Come on, give him your worship. 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 All of my, all of my. Give him your worship. Give him your worship. This is your moment. This is your moment. We worship you, God. We worship you. We worship you. We shake this place with our worship. We shake this place with our praise. We worship you. Things are happening in the atmosphere. Things are happening in the atmosphere. Things are happening behind the scenes. Things are happening when you worship. When you worship, if you want God's best, if you want God's goodness, worship, 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 worship. And he is the prize. He is the reward. He is the reward. You are the reward. You are the prize. Father, we worship you, Father. We praise your holy name. Father, we acknowledge you as King and a ruler of all. We acknowledge you as everything. You are everything. We thank you, Father. We thank you for life, for health, for strength. We thank you, Father, for our children. We thank you, Father, for our marriages. We thank you, Father, we're gainfully employed. But Father, even with all that, Father, we thank you because you exist. We thank you, Father, for your presence. That Father, you are the reward. You are the prize. Because of who you are, we worship you. Simply because you exist, we worship you. We magnify your name. We have no other agendas but to lift you up, to magnify your name, to exalt you. And this atmosphere that you're feeling right now, you can have at home. You can have in your car. You can have, it's a lifestyle. 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 This is how we live. This is how we move. This is how we breathe. Let it not be so that we live our lives on earth all this time and we get to heaven and he says, I never knew you. Depart from me. I never knew you. Let it not be so. 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 Greet your neighbor. Tell him you love him. Everybody watching on live stream, we love you. We're praying for you. Everybody, you are dismissed. God bless you. God bless you. We love you. Have a great night. Jesus.